Greetings, YouTubers. So this morning, let's go ahead and talk about a Bloomberg article. I've never done this before, and I really found this article interesting. It's Bloomberg's article talking about how Facebook is knocking startup companies out of VR. Minus the fact they only sourced one VR app in the entire report, and that one VR app happens to be a VR app that was modifying software illegally and was basically causing headsets not to function once installed. Wow, really, guys? You chose the worst app ever in human history to compare to Oculus's offerings. So the app I'm referring to is called Your Fit. And every time Your Fit, quote unquote, started getting better and started producing more updates, fixing things, fixing bugs, meeting Facebook's guidelines to get in the Oculus store, the first major thing started happening. They started having issues. They caused Quest headsets to crash because they didn't bother properly testing their code before releasing an update to the general public. Now, I love how Your Fit's founders and their dev team have said, oh, no, they've stolen my idea, they've done this. Really? Oculus provides developer kits that anybody can become a developer. They give you early access to beta software ahead of time so that you, the developer, can get your app ready for the next system update. Don't blame your coding errors on Oculus and Facebook. It's not Oculus and Facebook's fault that you couldn't keep up with coding. I'm sorry, because if you look at the pattern of it's broken, it's broken, it's broken, it stopped working, it's broken, claims by Your Fit, you'll see an interesting pattern of they didn't update the app ahead of time for the firmware's release. Now that's a no-no in developers. Developers, good developers on VR, always update their app first before a major firmware release or are already prepared for that major firmware release. In this case, Your claims that Oculus Move was stolen out of his code. Now, okay. I would say if it truly is stolen out of your code, sir, then I want to see you dissect and take apart the code for the Oculus Move. You can do that. The code's there. It's available to you as a developer. You can dissect the code and see if any of your code is inside the application. Did you? No, you just made baseless claims stating that because it looks similar, it's ours. That is not cool. Am I defending Facebook? No. I'm defending the fact that if you are a truly good developer and know your code and know what you are doing, then you should have been able to keep your app running. The one thing that shocked me is Your Fit did a nice job at working, don't get me wrong, when it was working, but it modified software. Your Fit's display panel displaying how much you were working out and stuff like this was being overlaid in games that your fit shouldn't have had developer access to, including Beat Saber and so many other games. That's not cool. You shouldn't have access to be able to hack other people's games to create a fitness app. You should have been able to create your fitness app without hacking games. And I find it funny that you keep blaming Facebook for your discretions and for your failures as a coder. I'm sorry, but the pattern that I keep seeing is you couldn't keep up with coding for it and getting it to work on beta software before its release, which tells me your code was trash. Then you stated that, oh, we tried to get it on the Oculus Store and they wouldn't allow it. Did you ever think that, geez, a few months before you tried to get it on the Oculus Store, your app crashed and locked out Oculus Quest headsets? Did you ever think that might be the reason why you didn't get on the Oculus Quest Store? Kind of a logical step. Bloomberg should have interviewed more people before they even posted this dumb article. Absolutely stupid article. You did one interview. You said multiple developers, multiple startups were being left out. But you didn't mention a single flippin' other starter except your fit. One company. Interesting that only one company seemed to have a problem with your policies of developing. Wow. That's interesting, don't you think? But life goes on. You know, it's called testing your code. If your code isn't tested properly, it doesn't work. If your code causes something to go wrong or crash, is it going to be approved to be put on a video game console, to be put on a VR platform, to be put on a product that millions of people have in their home? No. In fact, it would probably be pulled off the store and the developer would be asked to fix it, which I wish a lot more companies would do. Then we would stop getting the asset flips in Steam VR. Okay? So, you know, I'm not attacking Bloomberg for coming up with a wonderful story, because that was a good story, and I'm not even going to post a link to it, though, because it's laughable. And I mean laughable, because it's all the same old crap. FTC is investigating Facebook. We already knew this. FTC is already investigating Google and Amazon. We know this. So it's like, come on. We know all this stuff is coming. We know these investigations are coming. We know all of this. This is not new news to anybody here that's within an industry that changes at the drop of a hat. I mean, really? Come on. I just find it interesting that you're complaining about an app that crashed hundreds upon thousands, maybe, of Oculus Quest headsets, and you blamed Facebook. How is Facebook updating the firmware and you not updating your code their fault? It's not their fault. It's your fault as a developer for not updating your app before the update launched. Sorry. It's shortcomings. That sucks. Have a wonderful evening.